Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Chip Ritter.
Hi, everybody.
Dude, that was insane, man.
Thanks, man.
I didn't see you warm up to that. I didn't know you were going to go for the full jungle in that
song. That's Funky Walker.
Dude, Funky Walker. That's a play along on Drummy. If you guys are members, you can download it. Very cool song to play.
It is cool.
You killed it, man.
I tried really hard, man. I practiced for this. I've been thinking about this.
Behind your back.
And yeah.
Awesome. So welcome, everyone. I'm glad you're all here. Today is a Halloween lesson with Chip Ritter, and it's all about stick tricks to impress your friends. It's going to be a lot of fun. If you guys haven't seen Chip yet, he is probably one of the things you're known for, at least, is performing on David Letterman.
Stupid Human Tricks in May of 2004. Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah,
so
it
you
was
got
cool.
invited to play and juggle your sticks live on David Letterman.
Yeah, it was almost as nerve-wracking as this.
He's saying that this is more nerve-wracking than David Letterman.
Yeah.
I'm like, come on, man.
But yeah, that was a big day for me, a big break, you know.
No doubt. Yeah. I saw him at NAMM every year. You're always doing at the trick booth. You're always juggling sticks.
Yeah, Humes and Berg booth this last year.
That's
video
right.
went viral.
Yeah. 9 million plays or something
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, from Humes and Berg. That was cool.
He's also an instructor. Teaches locally, privately.
What aren't you going to be at NAMM?
I will be at NAMM.
Maybe I can talk them into letting me be at their booth a couple times.
Dude, we're gonna have a booth there. Come on down.
I'm gonna be down there
and juggle some sticks.
I'm gonna be eating the M&Ms.
For sure. Yeah, for sure. But anyway, follow him, guys, online. You can find him at Instagram, which is just at Chip Ritter. He's on Twitter at Ritter Method.
Ritter
I believe.
Method.
You can find him on Facebook as well, and his website is tripritterdrummer.com. He also has a cool book out. This is actually a really neat book. It's called Snare Force One, and it's a book designed for beginners. It's like a step-by-step on how to read basic
notation. It helps you learn how to read music, yeah.
Very cool. If you guys have any young drummers that you know that are really struggling, this might help you out. You also have a DVD called Stick Tricks right here. You teach 13 tricks on this.
Yes.
And you guys can find both of these on Amazon. We're also going to give two of these away, two whole copies of Snare Force One and Stick Tricks on YouTube. So once this video hits YouTube, you have 30 days. Submit a comment, but I want it to be more about what the best thing, normally we do what the best thing about the lesson was, but I want to hear your guys' opinions on what do you think about stick tricks. Do you think they're important to learn? Or do you think that you should just ignore that and stick with groove? There's obviously a place for it, I think, in drumming, but I'd like to hear your thoughts. So just post a comment on this video below and we'll randomly pick a winner for the book and the DVD. Okay, huge thanks to Aquarian Heads for supplying us with the heads and helping bring you out here.
Thank you, Aquarian.
Also Vic Firth, Heisty Cymbals, Humes and Berg bags and cases, and Trick Pedals as well.
And Prentice Practice Pads.
And Prentice Practice Pads too, cannot forget that. So you guys, if you're enjoying this and you're watching this on YouTube, we do this kind of stuff all the time on Drumeo, on inside of Drumeo Edge. And we're also filming a whole course with Chip on showmanship and things to do to better your live
and stage presence, yeah.
Stage presence and all that. So definitely sign up for that if you guys want to check it out. Also the play along we started with is included in there as well. But stick tricks to impress your friends.
Stick tricks to impress your friends.
What, are you going to teach us five?
Well, yeah, I was thinking about some good off-the-bat take-homes that our friends could maybe start practicing tonight if they wanted, and some a little more complex, yeah.
Awesome.
Five tricks to be, well, okay, we're going to cover the juggling thing really quick to explain it to some friends.
Yeah.
Because I get that a lot. Like, how does that actually happen? And not that somebody might be able to juggle at the end of this lesson, but definitely going to have some stuff we can practice.
Very cool. So what are your thoughts on stick tricks? I know that sometimes it's a controversial topic with drummers.
You know,
why is he spinning his sticks and stuff? What are your thoughts on that?
My personal thoughts are, I enjoy it. It's part of how I play.
Mm-hmm.
It's part of what I love about drumming. And there's something about the visual movement. You know, just the fact that we're drummers and we're moving and our sticks are moving in the air, that in itself is a visual thing.
Yeah.
And I appreciate that. So that's my thoughts on it as far as why I do it is because I like them. And I also enjoy it when I see other drummers putting that in there.
Mm-hmm.
I remember the first rock drummers like Robert Sweet and Tommy Lee and Ricky Rocket, all these guys that had the spins coming up out of the fog.
Yeah.
You know, I just thought that was really so cool. Bloss Elias from Slaughter.
That's right.
You know, those guys that had that look and feel to them, I just really got into it. And so a lot of my drumming roots are formed in showmanship, stick trick stuff. And it wasn't until later that I got into Lionel Hampton, you know, and the vaudeville type level, Gene Krupa type stuff, and Papa Joe Jones,
yeah,
were masters of showmanship when I started getting even more into it. So my thoughts are, they're good, I'm a fan of them. I'm thinking there's a reason they got the lights on stage, so let's show them something.
We're entertainers, right?
So I'm on the side of pro stick tricks.
Good. good. Well, I'm glad you are, and I think this is going to be cool. If you guys, like I said, even just pick one of these things out and try it in your next gig, I'm sure not only your bandmates might be impressed, but yeah, your friends are going to be impressed too.
They might dig it, yeah.
That's the thing, you go to
Stick
a show.
Stick tricks to impress your friends.
Right? You see a Tommy Lee going on this roller coaster upside down. That's a trick. It's not a stick trick, but it's very impressive. Anyway, let's get to it. What is the first trick? Well,
the first trick I'd like to talk about is the trick that I saw. One of the first exposures to stick tricks I had was watching a drummer named Robert Sweet perform with Stryper. Mm-hmm. My brother took me to see him. He had this gigantic yellow and black kit set to the side, and the cymbals were swinging on chains, and he was flailing up, and he had his sticks up in the air while he was playing. And I think he did something a little bit like this. Raising his hands up. So I think one of the first trick would be raising your hands. Mm-hmm. So do you want me to go ahead and do that now?
Yeah, sure.
Want to get into it?
So it seems pretty simple, but it adds so much to it.
Well, it's a trick in itself, just raising your hand. And some people, when they're really young and they're starting to do stick tricks, they ask, well, where do you start? And that's the best place to start is when a song stops. Mm-hmm. You know, Neil Peart from Rush throws a drumstick up on breaks of the songs. And if you're new to this, the best part would be in a break of the song, raise your stick up so everybody can see it. But to teach the trick, I usually do it while we're playing, and that's what I learned from him. So let's try to do, I would recommend doing the left hand.
Okay.
And we'll raise it on the and of four if we're counting eighth notes. So we'll play a quarter note rock beat, I'll count eighth notes out loud, and on the and after four, I'm gonna raise my hand to end up doing this. So I'm going to count out loud, one, and two, and three, and four, and one. That gives me the trick placed on the downbeat of one. And so practicing that over and over is kind of simple, but you know, it also, your balance is different when you raise your hand up, so you want to practice that. That's how I would start off with raise a hand. Then raising your right hand is gonna involve keeping the beat going. So you wanna keep the beat going no matter what, because our job is drummers. Our job as drummers is keeping time. So keeping the beat solid is important. So let's try to raise up with the right hand and do the same thing, but this time I'm gonna hit the left hand on one and I'll end up with one. So I'll count eighth notes and do the same thing and raise my right hand up. And that gives me two different positions with quarter note beats. So I would say raising your hand like that, and then if you want to do eighth notes, you want to keep the eighth notes going, try to start off again with the left hand, and I'll just raise it up on the and after four. Trying to get to the right hand, I'm going to have to lead a little bit with the left.
Okay.
Now, when I get hardcore friends of mine, I have some pro drummers that every now and then take lessons with me, and they talk about stick tricks. I recommend for any advanced drummers to start leading with your left anyway, because it really helps you balance it out. Mm-hmm. But you don't have to lead with your left on everything to get away with trying to raise the hand tonight. You could just start just by hitting with a couple notes. Like if I said, I'm really only hitting the hi-hat twice with my left hand in time. So I cover what I can't play on my right with my left.
Okay.
Sometimes I do tricks like that. These days I'm all over the place depending on what I'm trying to do, when and where. So it's not down to a science exactly right now, but that's a good place to start, is raising your hand on the and after four.
You know, you think about it, it doesn't seem like it's a trick, but when you see some drummer do it, it clearly stands out.
Oh, yeah.
It almost brings attention to what he's doing. I've seen Travis Barker do this. I've seen a lot of drummers do this. Steve Moore?
Yeah, he's most of what he's doing, he's covering.
Just moving his arms.
Yeah, he's covering out, doing this crazy blender windmill stuff, but you hear that beat still.
And that, of course, that's the number one thing as a drummer, is to keep good time and solid
groove. Time.
So we're not saying sacrifice your groove for these.
No.
But trying to get them in. Show us again how you would apply this maybe to just a quicker beat or something like that.
A quicker beat like that, I would just I'd do the same thing just a little sooner. I'd anticipate it and make sure that I'm trying to raise on the one. So I'm not thinking about where so much before or after. I'm thinking about where in time do I want to place the trick. I'm trying to hit that. Thank you. placing them like that.
Do you ever incorporate them into fills, solos?
Sometimes I do. I usually, if I'm doing fills, I have a lot of fills that I crutch on. Like some of us always kind of like the go-to fills. Mm-hmm. And one of the ones I almost always do is this. So. I don't know how good that looks, but that's one of the things I would do. If I'm doing fills, I'm trying to cover it up. Sometimes I don't feel too good with just like.
Yeah, love it. Simple.
Yeah,
simple.
Man.
Something
yeah.
that everyone can start.
It's a great trick you can start doing, and it for me, it's like a placeholder for almost all the other tricks, like your finger flips or your spins or something. That's where I would start doing them. People say, where do I want to do the spin? It's like, well, try it on the downbeat.
Okay. Okay, so when you're playing these, do you recommend, is it easier with your left hand to start with that or your right hand?
We had a conversation about that earlier. You were talking about that Mike Portney. He talks about doing this with his left hand so you can keep the beat going with the right. Mm-hmm. I'd recommend raising your hand with your left. And when it comes to the tricks, though, you're probably going to be better off doing the tricks with your right. So it's kind of like, I'm a fan of doing all of them.
Yeah.
I would recommend right off the bat, try to make sure you can get that left hand to go on one, no matter what you do to place it. That's going to give you the best in-time performance option for doing a trick in time.
Very cool.
The spin is going to go like that, or the flip's going to go like that. Anything. It's a good place to start.
Awesome.
Start on the one.
Start on the one, right. Okay, what's next? What's the next trick?
The next trick I wanted to talk about maybe would be a simple trick. It's a little more complicated than just raising the hand up, but the stick moves. It's called the finger flip.
Okay.
And I would say goes a little bit like this. So I'm just flipping the stick around halfway like this. I'm taking the stick with my first finger and my thumb, and then I'm going to let it drop down, pull these fingers inside, then let the stick go to the next finger. It's coming down. While my pinky's tucked in, I'm gonna let it come back down and then grab the stick again with the first finger and flip it around. I'm gonna hold it like this with the thumb and the first finger, take my first finger under that, this is my middle finger, it's coming around, the next finger, and then when it comes over this way, I'm gonna reach with this first finger and grab the stick and try to flip it into my grip. And when I do that, I'm trying to get the finger out of the way. Hence the finger flip.
Got it.
So. And this is a great trick. You know, stick tricks are really, if you want to get into them, you want to practice them. Mm-hmm. Because anything that you want to do live, you want to be familiar with enough to just control. If you want to enhance your showmanship, you'll just do this a lot. And I got this from, you know, one of my first drum teachers used to always tell me, he's like, well, practice it. Mm-hmm. I was like, how do you do that? And he's like, well, yeah, practice it. I watch movies or TV and I'm sitting there, I'm working on it.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's when you can't play, it's a great thing to get into if you're obsessed with drums like I am. And you're not allowed to play after a certain time at night, practice the finger flip.
Totally.
Yeah.
It gives you a lot more control with your stick, just the feeling of the weight.
Yep.
I found when I practice stick tricks, I drop my sticks less because I have ways to grab it if I knew it was coming out of my hand. Do you want to show us, we have a camera right up here, do you want to show us that a little bit slower?
Okay.
There we go.
Perfect. How's this, right there?
Yeah.
All right, so if I'm going to do the finger flip as a stick trick, I'm going to hold it like regular, and then I'm going to let go of my fingers here, tuck them back under. And then I'm going to take this first position, let go of my thumb with these two fingers. The stick is traveling towards me. I'm going to grab it with the next one, then let it come around. And when I take it around this way, I'm going to grab it and flip this into my grip again.
One more time. This is great camera angle. There you go. Awesome.
This finger, next middle, the next one brings it around. Then this comes up and grabs it and flips it into my grip. And you'll notice also that this goes halfway. If I start it here, the butt of the stick is now up here. And so it flips it like 180.
Okay.
You end up with each time. So another reason I like this trick is if I'm throwing the sticks up and I'm trying to catch them, if I get lucky, cool, it's the right way. But I stress not to focus on whether you catch it this way or that way. And if I ended up that way, I can always just kind of do that from there.
Back
I like the finger flip.
Okay. So show us how you would apply this.
So I would just apply it just like I did with the raising the hands. I'm going to pick the and after four, and I'm going to raise my hand up into the finger flip while I do it. So it's going to be like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1.
Perfect. So one more time, just for the people who are really wanting to learn this, show us all the different motions on this camera here. And also, people are asking, do you ever go through your pinky as well?
If you, Ray Luzier from Korn does this wicked spin through his pinky all the way around. And yeah. Sometimes I would if I wanted to do it all the way around, yes. But it's funny, when I do this all the way around, sometimes I use the pinky and sometimes I don't. So okay, I would have to say, yes, you do with the pinky all the way around if you want to.
Yeah.
That's the great thing about tricks is which way do you like them? Mm-hmm. My basic version of the finger flip doesn't go all around with the pinky, though. This one is very simply just goes like this. The first finger, let go of the thumb. Next one, and then go all the way around and grab it like this to flip it in. It seems to be a lot more control because this is a larger muscle group. You're really using these a lot more in drumming than mm-hmm. you are with the pinky. Mm-hmm. And I'm in a lot. I don't know why, but this is why I don't use the pinky. I'm in less danger, I think, of dropping it.
Yeah.
When I get down to the pinky, it's such a, you know, and that's a great trick. If you want to start at the beginning with the tip over there, go through the pinky and you'll be all the way around.
Yeah.
The finger flip, I just do that much.
Awesome. And you learned this one with both left and right hand?
I am not good at this with my left hand as much as I am with the right, but I tried that, yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. The main reason is I just don't do it anymore. I don't do the finger flip almost anywhere as much as I do fake spins and garden weasels, you know. I mean, I do all that stuff more so often, so this is I feel a little more confident just doing the finger flip with my right hand.
So what were the struggles that you had when you first started learning these? Like, any tips to help people out who are getting into this one?
Overall timing, working on your timing overall. The best tip I can give you is when it comes to playing in time, getting used to the motions and just try different things to get to where that feel is. That's the struggle I had was, well, let me give you an example. Getting over like that. When I just went, I had trouble getting over and making that sound congruent. Mm-hmm. Like I would go, you know what I mean? I'm like, what am I doing?
Yeah, yeah.
It sounded like I got hit in the head with a shovel. But trying to keep that left hand consistent, I guess, was the biggest challenge.
Totally.
So a lot of practice with the left hand. And it's weird though, what's funny is, we're talking about stick tricks, but when you practice with your left hand leading and controlling, leading and controlling the time, it opens doors in other ways on your playing musically. So mm-hmm. it's never a wasted investment in time when you're working on your left hand.
Love it. Show us that trick in motion one more time.
Okay, the finger flip in motion.
Very cool. I love when you crash, close it, and finish the end. That's great. Okay, so that's you might have to watch that a few times to get the actual motions. I know when I was learning that one, my stick was always falling, but step by step, and you'll eventually get it. Just go back and watch this as many times as you need to.
Yeah, and I recommend when you're working on these, do them away from the kit. Don't take your own kit practice time with these. Use mm-hmm. these. Dentist office, mm-hmm. principal, when you're watching movies at home at night when you can't play, work on that, work on the mechanics of the trick. And then when you're playing the kit, work on that raising the hand. And those two will work, you know, trust that process. Give yourself about a week to do it and you'll be up in no time.
Well, another thing too about raising your hand is you don't hit your cymbals when you're doing it. I don't know how many times I've done it and I've hit my tom rim and then my stick goes flying out there.
Yeah, that still happens to me sometimes. When there's another thing, my friends used to talk about, rule 52, don't take yourself so seriously.
Yeah.
There's lots of times I drop them. I'm just trying really hard not to, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Well, it makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. Next trick.
Next trick is called, well, this is one of the most famous tricks in the world. It's the fakie spin.
Yes.
It's a fakie spin.
Love it.
So what we do, here's my crash course on it, all right? I'm just gonna go ahead and
do it.
Here we go. We're gonna take our finger and a hand like this. We're gonna hold it straight and put the stick right between the first and the second finger. And what I want you to do when you're learning this, get your stick with, they have, some of them have drumsticks, right?
They should.
Get a drumstick. Everybody just try this with me. Put your stick in your first finger and your second finger like this in case you don't already have this down. Start wobbling the stick. Just start wobbling. Now, some people go in one direction, forward, backwards, doesn't really matter. Some people go like this where the stick is going away from them, mm-hmm. like if they're going up, and some people like me go this way. It doesn't matter what direction it is as long as you try to get it to pivot. So we're wobbling, and then as we're wobbling, put more pressure on one finger than the other, and you'll start to see the stick do this wobble thing. It wobbles more and turns into from a wobble to a pivot. Does that make sense?
Makes sense, yes.
So once this is doing this, the trick is going to be, most often it's going to ride up on you like that.
Yeah.
So the trick to learning this trick is to balance and be patient and try to stay in the middle so you can end up getting it to fan out. And the ultimate goal is to see a circle where the stick is. So you want to start wobbling it. Keep wobbling it, pick a direction, and try to get it like this. Most people start using the wrist a lot, mm-hmm. and that's good in the beginning, but once you get it going, the idea is to try to isolate that move and get it to do it on the hand, where the hand is more still, and the fingers are more letting that thing go out. I also noticed another thing too, the flatter your hand can be, the more splayed out your fingers are, the better the trick looks for some reason.
Look at that, yeah,
and
you're
then,
right.
Then there's one more, and I don't always do it. I teach this, so you know, we teach what we most need to learn.
Yeah.
But I try to get friends of mine that are doing videos. if you got one camera and this is the only camera on me and I do my trick, that's not gonna look as good
mm-hmm.
as that is. So I know I'm doing this to this camera. I'm thinking, okay, that's camera, but this doesn't look as good as this would.
Yeah.
So to be conscious of where you kind of aim in your spin is another good tip, I think. So start getting that to wobble, pick a direction. Once you get the direction, try to keep your hands still and let go when you need to on the fingers and tighten up when you need to on the fingers to keep that into a circle. Almost anybody I know that started trying this gets a little discouraged at the beginning because your muscles get tired real quick mm-hmm. and you're like, ah, bah, bah. Trust me, just keep at it. When you get tired, put it away, do something else, but then get it back. And pretty soon you're gonna be able to do this. And when you are able to do that, you're gonna see that this, even though this is so simple, it's one of the most effective all-purpose stick tricks that you could ever do.
Totally.
Some of the best showmen in the world use this. You know, like Tommy Lee and Blas Elias and those guys.
Yeah.
And they have it down to an art form.
Yeah.
You know, so and when you see those guys live and you're just like the fog and everything is just, then all of a sudden you just see the stick come up, you know, there's something cool about that.
Totally.
So I love when drummers spin their stick. So in actual application, once I've got that trick down, let's say that, and you even talked about, you learned this, didn't you? You learned this trick with your left hand,
I learned
right?
this with my left hand. Because yeah, exactly. So I was practicing it with like this, and I actually got pretty good with my right hand, but I realized I couldn't use it.
Yeah.
Because I'm always using my right hand. Now, I've seen other drummers right-handed do it, but I learned it with my left just so I could play.
Did you say it took you a while, though?
Took me a long time.
You got to be patient with it, but it'll pay off.
But when you can do it with your left hand, now you can keep riding.
Yeah.
You know, and you can pop it.
That's exactly. Okay, so if you're watching us live at home, you're like, I want to do stick tricks, but I'm really not good at this one. Right, I'm not good at my left hand. I want to do it with my right hand. Well, then go back to the raise your hand portion in this video and practice that so you can pull up your right hand and do that first.
Makes sense.
It's gonna, you know, you're gonna, I would like you to learn both because it's fun to be able to not have to worry about which one can I do because I can.
Yeah.
I want to be able to do any one that I feel like doing.
So cool when you go back and
fakie
forth.
Fakie spinny, yeah.
Fakie spinny.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's pretty good.
I would say that's the oldest trick in the book.
That is one of the oldest. Yes, sir.
There you go. I like one tip that you gave me before. You said when you're going to practice these, make sure you bring a lot of pairs of sticks with you.
Yeah.
Because nothing's worse than having to go pick the same stick
and
up.
It saves you so much practice time to just grab another stick so you don't have to go run around and go get one. Get some sticks if you're going to do stick tricks. Get some sticks together.
Totally. Yeah. So the fakie spin, I've seen some drummers do it between these two fingers. What do you recommend? These two or these two, or does it matter?
I recommend the first finger and the middle finger right there. That's what I recommend. I'd like to get you going with that wobble. Start turning it into a pivot one direction or the other. And again, this back thing, a lot of really famous rock drummers do this backwards thing. Mm-hmm. They hold it up and it's really cool because you're whipping your hand and you can help start the stick by whipping your hand back. Mm-hmm. But I just like coming out of it. I like having the direction like I'm going to hit something.
Yeah.
You know, rather than... But either way, it's all a matter of preference. That's the hard thing about teaching stick tricks too, Dave. It's so personal.
I know.
It's like, you gotta go with what you like.
Yeah.
And that's really what got me to where I am. I just kept chasing what I like about them. So this is really my version of stick tricks.
I know the one direction, but I can't do it the other. I've tried, but for some reason, I'm so implanted with the one direction that I do it in.
I think you're lying to me. I think you haven't just sat there and said, I'm going this way.
Well, that's
true. We're going this way. Have you? Have you sat there and really tried?
You know, maybe a couple hours of my life in total, but not enough, obviously.
How much is a stick trick worth? How much time should I spend?
Right. Love it, man.
Right on.
So that fake spin, the finger flip, the hand up.
Yep, the raise the hand.
What would be the next one on the list?
I would say throwing sticks.
Tossing the stick?
It would be into throwing the sticks, and that's just so I can pop them up in the air. I'm trying to impress my friends.
Yeah.
You know, in a little bar down at home playing, and there's friends of mine lined up at the corner. And there's nothing cooler than busting a little bit and having them look back and, like, freaking them out a little bit, you know? So throwing the sticks. To start throwing the sticks, I'd recommend you get a bunch of sticks and you go outside, out in the backyard where you're not going to break your mom's anything.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. So you can stand up. You're standing up and you're throwing the sticks. When you stand up, you can throw the stick over here and just step over. Mm-hmm. It's way easier to catch something when you're standing up than if you're sitting down. So stand up. Go throw the sticks up with each hand, whatever one you want to do the trick with. Usually it's the right with if you're right-handed.
Yeah.
So you go out and practice that standing up, and then go get your drum stool and put it outside. I know, it's getting serious, right?
Yeah, no, it's good.
But if you want it to be reliable, then you want to practice it. Mm-hmm. And to get it, you know, I think when it comes to throwing stick tricks, it's about percentages. Mm-hmm. What are the odds that I can get that up and back in time so I can keep the groove going? Because it's always cooler to me if you do a stick trick and you keep in time. Mm-hmm. So then sit down and try to do it sitting down. When you're sitting down, there's only so much room for error now because there's only a window of where I can catch. Mm-hmm. Then the next thing I would say is turn a practice pad and go outside and try to hit and throw up. I'm hitting and I'm throwing. So everything you see me do that I'm doing like this, it seems like I got it all down, usually because I practice so much sitting down in other ways. Plus, you don't want to damage your drum because of the stick tricks.
True.
So it's a good idea to take your stool and your practice pad outside and try hitting, throwing. Once you got that, when you're trying to hit, throw, some drummers pop the drumstick. Like, they got this rock thing. They go, boom, just throw it down and bounce it off the snare. That's not what I'm doing. I'm trying to make it look like it's doing it. So I'm going to hit the drum, and when the stick comes up, the rebound, the natural rebound is going to come up. I'm trying to fake it as if the stick just popped up. I think that's a good version of a fake, like the stick just came up by itself. And that's another reason I like throwing the sticks. You ever when you were a little kid, didn't you ever like throw a ball up and see the little moment of weightlessness?
Mm-hmm.
That's just, I like that. Mm-hmm. I don't know why. I like watching the stick go up like that. So throwing it. When I'm throwing it while I'm playing, I'm usually popping it off the snare. Mm-hmm. So I don't really do too much of the hi-hat throwing. Mm-hmm. But I suppose you could get really good at throwing and hitting and throwing on any instrument that you wanted. Mine's mostly on the snare. And I would do two or four. When it comes up, I'm trying to catch it like on one, three. catching it on three or one. So how I would go about doing that is go slow at whatever rate of speed I can do it by myself. And you notice—
You caught it right on the downbeat.
Yeah, I'm trying to. And you notice what I was doing with my left hand.
Yes, you're covering.
I'm using what we talked about. I'm covering whatever is needed, or I'm trying to cover whatever is needed while I'm popping it up. Same thing if I do this, I'm playing with my right hand. Yeah. It's not an exact science, but that's basically what I'm doing, hitting and throwing.
Seems simple enough, but I know in practice it isn't.
Yeah, it's not easy to get off the bat, but that's one of the best ways the best advice I could give anybody that wants to start doing airborne tricks.
Yeah.
High risk, but you know, that's thing that's kind of cool about it is like, dude, he's playing and the stick pops up. When I've seen drummers do that, I was just, wah!
Well, the really impressive one, I was going to get you to show us it. I know you might not be able to pick it up right away, but the one where you throw it behind yourself.
Oh, the backflip.
The backflip, come on, look at that.
Yeah. Well, the backflip, let me tell you a little story real quick about where this came from.
Okay.
I'm in high school, I'm in jazz band. My friend Sonny Petrocelli is playing the drums. And you know, when there's two drummers in jazz band, you're trying to wait, you gotta get on the drum set. So your buddy, the drummer's over here, right? I'm you, yeah. Right? And I'm, where I'm playing, and Sonny's playing, and we're going, da, da, da. And all of a sudden the band director goes, horns, take it from letter C. So this is going on, right? So while this is going on, one day Sonny goes, and I was just like, what? That. And it started this little fierce competition thing.
Who can throw the best trick?
While we were bored out of our minds doing the coda for the horns to practice their parts, it became, so that's really where that motivation for that came, because I just wanted to see the look on my friend's face when I did it, and I did it, and he freaked out. It was cool. So I learned this trick by going outside and throwing a tennis ball, flipping it with my wrist to flip up and see if I could get it in front of me and to catch. That's where I started learning that. Usually tennis balls are good to, well, with juggling or whatever, but tennis balls are good to start it off from behind you to get it in front of you. And the thing is, stand up, go outside, get some sticks. Be careful because you could hurt your shoulder doing this. But the motion is another, like I'm using the stick as a pendulum. So when I'm flipping, I'm using my wrist and the stick in one little unit to kind of carry it over.
Okay.
It's deceiving. It's really deceiving on how hard you got to go, how much force you've got to go to get it in front of you.
You mean too much or too little?
You have to go more than you think.
Really?
To get this thing to get in front of you. So that's what I recommend when you're starting to learn it. Just try to get the stick in front of you. If you can get it to go in front of you, then you can probably get it to come into what I would say is a target area, or your what's successful, like the rate, what are my percentages that I can catch it?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Can I catch it when it comes up here? Usually something around here I'm pretty good at.
Yeah.
And tennis balls help with that too, but throwing it up is pretty cool.
And the icing on the cake is when you can lay down a good groove and do these in time. I mean,
yeah, well, or play something in time, keeping it steady. That's kind of like the cool thing about it, yeah.
Yeah. So start with just throwing it up.
Start with trying to just throw the stick up.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then work that into where you can pop it off the snare. And then, again, if I go back to the beginning, where's the best place to start doing tricks while I perform live with the band? It's going to be wherever a song stops. That's going to be your first places.
Okay.
Like if you got this going on, but you can't go like that and play, you can't keep it going, then wait till the song stops. Pop! You know what I mean? That's the where you want to start your stick tricks if you're getting into this and you want to try to incorporate it. Start where the song stops.
Okay.
First.
So this brings us to the epitome of stick tricks from you, and that's juggling.
Juggling.
Now, obviously, this is going to be tough to learn in one small little section of a live lesson, but hopefully you can pick something up from it. Chip, tell us how to juggle a stick.
Tell us how to juggle a stick. Well, first off, you'd have to be able to juggle some balls first, some tennis balls. It really helps you to have that already there. But if you can, here's the process. And all of this is on a pad with a chair outside where you can't break your mom's anything.
Yeah.
You want to be out there. All right, okay, so I'm going to hit and throw the stick. I've got that. Now I want to try to hit and throw the stick to my other hand. Okay, cool. Well, I want to throw that stick to my other hand. If I can't throw the stick up with my left hand and catch it, probably not going to be able to juggle. That's, most of the people are out on that one.
Yeah.
So throw and catch with my left hand, I'm out.
Yeah.
But if you're into that, if you really want to juggle, you'll practice enough to get your left hand to do that. So when I'm juggling, I'm basically hitting back and forth. And I remember being a young kid in my grandmother's backyard at Christmas with these little juggle things. And I was juggling them up, and it was, here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus. And I figured that I could get that little weightlessness right on the downbeat of the song. And I was geeking out on it. I was just so happy about that. Then remembering that in Seattle before a drum lesson, I remembered that moment and I thought, wow, wouldn't it be cool if I could play and juggle at the same time?
Yeah.
So this is where it started. And I just started hitting, throwing, and catching to the other hand. So my hands are continually moving. So what I'd say, once you can throw to either hand, try to hit, throw, catch. I'm gonna hit, throw, catch. Hit, throw, catch. And while I do that, I'm gonna move the hands. Does that make sense?
Makes sense. Keep doing it till the front angle might be the best one.
Let's try this. Hit, throw, catch to the hand. Then, once I've got that, then the trick's gonna be throw it up and catch it. I'm gonna have to throw this stick up, and then I'm gonna have to throw the other stick over to the other hand, and then catch that stick with the hand that I just threw it from.
Whew.
So that would be outside, so you don't break your mom's anything. Trying to throw the stick over and weave the one that I'm not catching with under. So now. I'm just doing the same thing backwards. With that, if you can do that enough, you start doing it where you can throw another stick in there.
Show that again with this camera. Keep it on this camera angle.
Okay. I'm hitting, throwing, catch with each hand.
And notice, if you guys, he's hitting the snare with his hand.
I'm practicing with my hand on the pad outside that first. I'm actually doing that. And we talk about that in the DVD too. With tennis balls, you can start hitting and throwing and catching. But the process is basically, that's it. It's really hard to do when you're new at doing it. But then once you can do that, you want to try to throw in another stick.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're hitting. Which is a sped up version of what I was doing with another stick. So, and that in itself could be cooler. You know what I mean?
Unreal, man.
So when it comes to playing a beat, and another thing we talked about giving our friends who are watching the Drumeo Live here, the secret or whatever to the juggling, when I'm juggling and playing a beat, not hitting all of those. I'm doing like a Charlie Watts,
mm-hmm.
Rolling Stones type of groove. And the way I'm accomplishing that is hitting twice. So I would practice twice. Twice with each stick, and then I'm hitting this twice with my left hand, and then I'm hitting the snare, and then the hi-hat.
Okay.
So I'm going like this. I'm juggling like I was here. And I'm juggling while I'm playing a beat.
Dude, that is impressive, man.
Thanks, man.
And I also have to say, we have overhead mics hanging down here. Our roof isn't that big in the ceiling, and not once today has he hit any of the mics, any of the cameras, or the ceiling.
How much is that one worth?
You don't want to know.
I'm just kidding.
We'll just take it out. You're paid there, Jim.
I get paid?
Yeah, you get paid.
Mom, check it out.
In appreciation and thanks from the online members.
Wow. Though. You guys are awesome.
That's enough, right?
It is. Just the appreciation. I really am happy to be here. You guys have no idea. Thank you so much for your support.
Dude, you were nervous. You're killing it, man.
This is a big deal to me. All my Facebook friends were like, dude, drum yo, yeah! You know, well, and I'm like, so dude, glad. I don't want to drop the ball or the stick.
There you go. But very cool stuff. Now, those are just five simple, I shouldn't say simple, that juggling wasn't, but the first couple were simple tricks mm-hmm. you can all learn.
Raising your hand.
Yep.
The little finger flip.
Yep.
Some fake spin.
Mm-hmm.
And throwing the stick.
There you go. Now, I want you to play us a little solo.
Okay.
If that's cool.
I'll play a solo.
I've seen him play the solo. It's awesome. You use a lot of the tricks in there. While you're doing the solo, guys, if you have any questions for Chip, get them in now. And if we can't get to all of them, we are doing a live interview /Q&A with Chip tomorrow for all you Edge members. But have fun with it.
I'd like to do an impression to start it off. Is that okay?
Okay, go for it.
I'm going to do my impression of Louis Armstrong uh-huh. impersonating Louis Prima. Impersonating King Louis from the Jungle Book.
Well, I'm the king of the swingers, Lord, the jungle VIP. I hit the top and had to stop. That's what's been bothering me. I want to be a madman cub and stroll right into town. I'm sick of being like the other ones. I'm tired of monkeying around.
Thanks, man.
You had some Led Zeppelin in there.
A little bit of Led Zeppelin.
That's great. Some Eye of the Tiger as well.
A little bit of Eye of the Tiger.
Oh, man.
Cool. I like it. It's my solo, man.
Yeah, the Louis Armstrong thing in the beginning was
I'm great. Trying to. My Facebook friend said, go do it. I'm like, there you go, man. Let's do it.
Well, you slayed it, buddy.
Thanks, man.
Catch your breath. Grab a drink of water.
Thank you, sir.
Got a couple questions for you, too. And yeah. And you are going to play us out with one more song at the end, correct?
Yeah, I got a song now.
Beautiful. All right. So this is a question from Greg. He says, Chip, how did you get to be so dang cool?
First off is I signed up for courses on Drumeo.com.
Oh, now you're being too kind.
And I was taking lessons from the best teachers out there.
But you realized that there wasn't any lessons on how to juggle your sticks, so you emailed me.
Appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Vince has a question. Says, how do you cover up when you accidentally drop a stick?
Rule 52, don't take yourself so seriously. When you cover up is the same way you would cover up if you made a mistake while playing. You go for it and you try to, if it's a big foul and I drop the stick, let me try to drop stick. Like, let's make it, okay. Let me see what I would do.
Just don't hit me.
This is what I would do. That's what I would do.
Yeah.
9 times out of 10.
Smile,
I would just go
off.
Right again and go into it again.
Obviously, you have a nice a pair of sticks close by that you can grab.
Yes.
Always. You have two. You have some on the right and some on the left.
Yes.
Which is great. Here's a question.
I hope that answered the question.
Yeah.
That's what I would do.
I'm sure it does. Here's a question from James. Oh, not a question, just a comment. Just saw Striper last weekend with Robert Sweet. Still does all the cool stick tricks, which
That's
is
awesome.
Great. Yeah, he's great. Here we go. Here's from Already Not Yet, member name it, and he asks, how do you go from the stick between your fingers back into the grip? How do you get into that spin too from playing?
Well, I start off with the regular grip, and then I get my finger in over real quick. I'm trying to just grab it and flip my finger over. So if I'm playing and I want to get in the spin, I just go like that. And sometimes I actually do hit like that. So that's how I do that.
Got it.
I'm just crashing. I'm coming out of that hitting. It's another reason I like the direction I'm doing, because it seems to be easier. It's more intuitive just to hit. It's really just this.
Just your.
That's how
finger.
I'm doing it.
Yeah. It's funny, actually. We had Carmine a piece out, and he showed his way of holding his sticks is through the, actually playing through these two knuckles here.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, well, why would you do that? That doesn't seem like a very good grip at all. He's like, but then I can spin it really easily.
He can spin it faster that way, yeah.
So he plays because.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if you want, you can always do it that way. Aiden L says, can you show us that backflip? I'm assuming behind the back. Slowly again with this camera. So Taylor, can you switch to the, ooh, that might not work. That, yeah, that one there.
All right, this flip is, I'm trying to get the stick to go in front of me. So first of all, I'm just gonna throw it and throw it hard. When I first try to do this, the stick will go straight that way. What I'm really trying to do is just swing it around. So I want to have that stick do its momentum. And I'm also contorting a little bit. There's a little bit of contortion going on. Like I'm shrugging my shoulder. Same thing with that. A crossover.
Okay.
Really, it's a more about, you know, you get the whole pendulum feel from the stick, and you swing it so it can carry itself over. Or that's the idea that I'm thinking. It would just kind of, it's one of those things where take your sticks outside. Take like a bunch of your sticks, take one stick and be like, yo, I am going to throw this stick from behind my back in front of me, because Chip promised me if I do that enough, I'll get to where I can get that stick in front of you. Once you get that stick in front of you, it's almost over, because that's just a matter of slowing it down enough to get it into that target range where you can catch it.
Mm-hmm.
I hope that made sense.
Yeah, no, it did. Watch the video again if you want. That camera angle actually did a good job of showing exactly what it was. Question from Post Cami High says, I would like to see Chip explain on his left hand leading while he does his stick twirls in the right hand. Maybe a few exercises on how to develop that independence to switch.
Developing the independence to switch would be, I'd say, just go for a straight up lesson in leading with your left.
Okay.
Start off the bat, just like look at it analytically.
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing with your left hand? Well, 9 times out of 10, I'm hitting together, or I'm hitting in between. So I'm going to hit all of the downbeats and all the upbeats, and I would just practice that. Or have you ever heard of a grid, which you have that one sequential place in 16th notes where it goes from the 1 E and a 2 E and a 3 4 to the E E E and then the and then the That's a great exercise for leading with your left.
So show us that.
I would try to think of 16th notes and I go through each of the four sets. practicing that is a really good one. Also, just your fundamental downbeats and upbeats. 1, 2, 3, 4, and all the ands. If you can do that, then you could do almost all of your eighth note grooves, and I'd say start there. What's a good eighth note groove? Do you know this one? If you know all your downbeats, you're going to be able to do most of it. If you know all your upbeats, you can do the whole thing because these are two upbeats. Same thing here. So if I've practiced this, then I've got everything I need to do this. So my answer to your question is to practice that way with leading until you get all through your eighth note beats. Mm-hmm. And any of the 16th note beats, the same thing applies. Mm-hmm. I would try to learn whatever the beat I'm doing with my left hand. If I have this beat, then I want to make sure I can play. And if I can't, then I'm going to slow it down and repeat it. Slow it down and repeat it. Mm-hmm. If I can't do that, I'm going to slow it down and repeat it. And just another thing about that practice, practice for stick tricks sometimes gets tedious. And one of the things that has carried me through is I just keep the vision of, man, is this something I want bad enough? Mm-hmm. And just keep that vision of how cool would it be, man, if you could lead with your left and do those beats. Just think about that when you're getting discouraged the next time. Just say, you know what, Chip, I promise you it's going to pay off. Mm-hmm. I promise you.
Love it. Love it. And I can tell you one thing. Once you learn those one trick, you can use it for the rest of your life.
And all of, please lead with your left hand. All of the leading with your left hand is going to help when you do anything. Mm-hmm. Any of that stuff. You know, going. Any of that stuff around the kit that your left hand is involved with. You know, it's 50% of everything you do with your hands is your left hand.
That's right. Last question and more of a comment, but there is a question at the end. Bonesy says, this lesson is like being at the gym, repetition and muscle development.
Yes.
Absolutely. A lot of drumming is actually.
A lot of it is. Yeah, yeah, you're right.
The question is, can I get your DVD on other sites or just Amazon?
They have it on Mel Bay, and there's some other sites that you can get it on.
There you go. Or you guys can win it. I've got a DVD.
Somebody
and a book.
Win it, please.
Yeah, exactly. We're going to give two copies of both of those away. And all you have to do is below this lesson, once it's on YouTube, just leave us a comment. What do you guys think about stick tricks? Are they cool or are they lame? Or do you think you should learn them? Or should you just focus on groove? Now, I don't think anyone here would deny that a drummer's job is timekeeping and groove. So we're not saying that this is going to take place of your normal practice.
We're saying this is a great way to do stick tricks to impress your friends.
Absolutely. And then if you like it, you dig it, keep trying some new ones. There's a plenty of other tricks out there, like in your DVD F13. And for all you guys watching out there too, we are filming a complete course, a full course on showmanship and stage presence. And we're going to talk about some extra little tricks that you can do like that with Chip. Yep. And it's going to be on Drumeo Edge. We also are doing a full interview/Q&A with Chip tomorrow as well. For those who have questions that we weren't able to get to today. So make sure you sign up for Drumeo for that. Chip, man, that's it.
Hey, man, thank you.
Thank you.
I thank you guys for showing up. I really appreciate the opportunity. Thanks for having me up here.
Very unique lesson, man.
Right on, man.
I'm glad we got you on Drumeo. Thanks again to all the sponsors who helped out and to all you guys watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Now, you're going to play us out with something.
Yes.
It's a song that we are familiar with.
Yes, it's a cover that I was in a band called 22 Black, and we did this cover of the song.
There you go.
And I love this song.
You got to load it up there, Taylor? Yes?
Yes.
All right. I will see you guys later, Chip.
Thank
you. Enjoy.
Thank you again.
Cheers.
Red just got a longer. Things you never, never learned before. Like I before, eat except after seeing right to us to mix from.